We're going to look at an example of one of these finite state automata for this infinite XOR function. The first thing we want to do is we want to figure out what should our states be and which one of them should be the start state. So when we have an XOR, when we're trying to compute an XOR, we're just asking this question, are there an even or an odd number of ones in this string? So the two states that we probably want to have is I want to have maybe one state that represents or that I've seen an even number of ones so far. I want to have another state that says that I have seen an odd number of ones so far. Since we have to read our input string sort of one character at a time, from left to right without ever going back, we can imagine how is it that I would determine whether or not there were an even number of ones or an odd number of ones in that input string. Maybe if we were to try to do this in some sort of pseudocode, we could say, whenever I see a one, I might toggle whether or not I've seen an even or an odd number so far. So when I see that first one, then that means that I'm going to have seen an odd number of ones. If I've seen an odd number so far, and I see another one, then that must mean I have an even number now. If I've seen an even number of ones so far and I see another one, that must mean I have an odd number so far. Whether I've seen an even versus an odd number of ones should be enough information for me to sort of keep around in order to determine what my answer ought to be at the very end. Now that we've identified what our states ought to be, let's pick which state it is that we want to start in. So before I have seen any inputs, how many ones have I seen? Zero. And is zero odd or even? Yeah, so zero is an even number. So in this case, we're going to say that this even state is going to be our start state. The way we're going to denote our start state is we kind of put this empty arrow coming into it from nowhere. So that says before you've done anything else, that's the state that you're in. The next thing we want to do is figure out which state or states are the ones that represent your answer should be one. So in this case, we want to return one for this function whenever we've seen an odd number of ones. So this odd state is the one where if we finally were in that state, if after reading the whole string, we had seen an odd number of ones, then that means we want to return one. The way that we denote that that was one of the final states is we double circle it. So double circled states, those are the ones where we return one. Any other state, any single circled state, that means that if we end in that state, then we should return zero. As we go through this, as we're computing on this automaton, we're going to read one bit at a time from our input. And if we're currently in even, so if our current state is the even state, we want to switch to odd whenever we see a one. So the way that we write that rule down is we say even transitions to odd when the input is a one. So it says whenever you're in the even state, plus you're looking at a one in your input, then the next state you should be in is the odd state. You should update your state to be odd. Or when you're in even and you see a zero, you should stay in even. You haven't changed the parity of the number of ones that you've seen, so you're going to stay in even. And then we do a similar thing with odd. If I've seen an odd number of ones and I get a one as my input, then now I've seen an even number of ones, so I update my state. If I've seen an odd number of ones and I see a zero, I haven't changed the parity of the number of ones that I've seen, so I want to stay in odd. So we can run through an example of what this looks like. So does somebody just want to call out some zeros and ones for an input string? Okay, so this is our input string. So we're going to see if the automaton that we drew here gives us the right answer for this input string. So let's sort of walk through what happens. So what I want to do is I want to know kind of what is my current state and what state do I start in? Even. So that is this even state. So before I've read any input, I begin in that even state. So then the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to say, well, I'm in the even state and I'm going to process this first character. So we're going to read all of the characters in my string from left to right, never looking back. So we can read them once. And we can never look back. So if I'm in the even state and my current character is a zero, what is my next state? Yeah, so we're still going to be in even. So my state is going to be updated from even to even because we're going to sort of follow this transition here. So this self loop is the one that we're going to take because that is the one where we said you move on that transition whenever you saw a zero. So we saw A0, so we take that self loop, updating our state to even. And now we have read this character. We're never allowed to read it again. Okay, so now we're in even. I'm looking at a 1 as the next character. Where do I go? What's my next state? Odd. So this gets updated to odd because we are going to say I'm in even and I see a 1. So I follow the state, the transition where there was a 1 that was labeled on there. So I go to odd. So then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to say I can never read that character again. I'm going to look at a 1. I'm in odd. When I'm in the odd state and I see a 1, then I move to the even state. So I'm going to update my state to even. And I can't look at that character ever again. I have a 0. So I'm in even. I see a 0. So I stay in 0. So I can't look at that again. And then I'm going to stay in 0 again. And then I'm going to stay in 0 and even again. And then finally, I'm going to do that final transition to odd. So now we see that we're in odd. I've read all of the characters. So I just say, was I in one of the final states or was I in one of the non-final states? Since the state that I'm in, that odd state, is double circled, that means it was final. So this here tells me that I want to return 1. So now we can check. Did the right thing happen? I had 3 ones in this string, so the XOR of that string should be 1.